Watch out!
There's also a giant tree at the studio, a magnolia tree, which is very common here, and the leaves go all the way down to the ground, so you go underneath it, and it's like an umbrella inside, and I thought, it sounds good in there.
I'm singing a lot, and we're doing overdubs, and we're tracking a couple of new songs. So we just have 3 weeks here. And then we go to London and we mix the thing in 10 days and that's it. I might see you in London.
Thank you.
What's that?
The room.
A dusty tourist destination that has seen better days is where you ran off rail. It lost its sheen in the first early spring when the dreams of the 1980s failed. A few bad choices, some dubious concerns. What you're offering, what you're offering, I don't know what you're offering, you're offering. Picking up, I'm moving on. I've got to leave, I'll find my way. Thank you very much. I'm an awful writer, my address changes too often to try to keep in touch. I turn away in broken phrase, you say. Kick the traces, kid, kick up a little dust. Kick the traces, kick up a little dust. What you're offering, you're offering.
And thank you so much for participating in our live experiment tonight.
Uncensored.
Just don't care.
Good evening. And thank you so much for participating in our grand experiment tonight. In the event that anyone wandered in and has no idea what's going on here, a brief explanation. We're REM and this is what we do. When you're not looking. This is a rehearsal. It's our fifth night of five nights. It's the shortest tour that we've ever done. In fact, it's not a tour because this is not a show.
This is not a show.
In listening to your own music, with other people in the room or in the car, or with the work that I've done as a film producer, the same thing works with film. You're listening or watching with people who haven't heard it, might be fans, might not be fans, might love music, not know your music, might love film, not know this director's work. And the second something is off or not right, it's not that they're reacting or not reacting the right way, it's not that they're laughing at the punchlines or not laughing, or that they're applauding a great chorus. It's not really how they react as much as how you react to being in the same space with them, hearing it or watching it for the first time. And that's where I think Dublin was really brilliant for us, because, you know, in a way we'd sequestered ourselves on stage between the three of us, and then with Scott and Bill playing backup guitar and drums, obviously. We knew when a song was working or not working. Every night afterwards, we would pretty much gather, you know, in Peter's dressing room and talk about it. And some of them really worked and some of them didn't.
REM and this is what we do when you're not looking. I'd like to explain what's happening this evening. This is a live rehearsal. It's the first time, actually the fourth night of five that we're attempting this experiment in terror for ourselves. What this involves is we have 11 new songs. You just heard two of them. And we are midway through recording an album and decided that rather than rehearsing in our rehearsal space in Athens, Georgia, we would come to Dublin and we would invite a select audience of people with impeccable taste.
The day before the first show, Paul McGinnis, YouTube's manager, came back and he was like, oh, this is quite interesting. Was, and have you just consoled yourself to the fact that every note of your new record is going to be available in, you know, digital form?
In about 5 minutes.
Yeah, tomorrow night at midnight. And the idea of that is, yeah, you know, I really think that most of the people who buy the bootlegs and who download the live shows and all that stuff, they're the ones who are going to buy the record anyway, unless it's horrible. But to get people kind of fired up about where we are as a band, that was kind of part of the thought process that, well, you know, we have confidence in these songs. We can go out and play basically 45 minutes worth of stuff that no one's heard.
The last thing I remember is climbing up the stairs.
Scott put down, Bill put down the crazy drums, Scott put down the ugliest bass sound on earth, and Mike did that crazy organ, and it was like finished, and then we got to Grouse Lodge, and everyone's like, well, you know, the acoustic guitar sound isn't all that great, and you basically walked out, you weren't even really in front of the mic, and I tried to replace it, and it just didn't have the vibe, you know, I mean, the sound is maybe less than optimal, but it's totally in the moment, and that's kind of what you look for, is a real lived experience captured.
And it actually sounds like the chaos of what, you know, of what the song is about.
Yeah,
just being turned on your head. And the whole world is coming under.
It's always good if you don't know what you're doing. I can't hear you. Okay. All right. Okay, great. Done. water. No. Water. Fuck. See, it's hard to sing it out and still get it on the note. It's, go ahead, do it again. Water. 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 Done. It's easy when you're good.
Yeah, I mean, it's got this. This is a good mix. So it's just weather. It's those things like you're getting.
It sounded splashy without being harsh in that high end, like that.
Yeah, I think now that I've taken that frequency out as well, which we should just have a quick listen to the middle section, just play it loud, okay, without it being too annoying for anybody. To see is that still there?
Okay.
Yeah. You're not fine.
Playlist. I don't want to miss it at the end of the world.
That's a
VH.
Yeah.
Okay.
With that frequency taken out from the room mics. So that's a good mix.
Okay.
But I'll spin my way right through it. Things enthusiasts, Jack Brook. That's the monster on the moon. As you're circling the room, the music will provide the light. You cannot resist. You cannot resist. You cannot resist. And the web box that gets
Demoed it was like 5 minutes long, and it was me playing drums and me and Mike playing synthesizers and guitar and bass, and Michael just said, well, you know, I've got great parts for it, but it goes like this, and he just actually took tape and, you know, I guess it was digital in those days, and edited it down so that I think mine went verse chorus, bridge, verse chorus. This version goes verse chorus, bridge, verse chorus, outro. And so it dumped like half the song in the middle. Yeah. And it's kind of cool. It means that there are four parts that go right in a row that are all completely different, and then it kind of starts over, which it's not a way that I would have written it, but it's really effective and it's different. I don't know if people.
And I was just thinking, what would Mark Bolan do? That's my like. I think T-Rex, for me anyway, arrangement-wise, was a huge influence on this record. I can't even say why I haven't listened to a T-Rex record over any other recent.
It's not like I'm working hard or anything, but I'm just kind of jet-lagged enough that I really want to focus, and if I go out regularly, I think I'm going to be unfocused.
So let's get the levels up and the bells on them.
Sure. You know, getting my PJs on and getting in bed and, you know, just reading or watching a DVD is a great, great thing.
Perfect is the enemy of the good.
Perfect, yeah. I don't even know what it means, but we could spend a year trying to get it perfect, where right might be just what you want. You know, I was kind of trying to remind myself, let's keep the rough edges. Let's make sure that, you know, we don't think, well, that's kind of fucked up, because fucked up is what I like a lot, you know, musically.
Sounds great.
It didn't bother me. Can I do a little when you get ready, do a little ratio change on those background vocals?
You can do it now.
The harmonies, the can we have the high harmony louder and the third, or the high octave louder and the harmony, the third quieter?
Okay, so
I can show you which ones. It's too sweet.
I think each of us are confident, not only in our ability to kind of sit down and hash it out with each other, but also our abilities as songwriters, arrangers, lyric writers, you know. They're finally unafraid to say that line isn't that great, or can you work on that a little bit more? And I don't get, you know, horribly offended, cross my arms and go off into 5 days over a lyric. It just doesn't matter that much.
Doesn't kill me, the government will. Gotta get that out of my head. It's a new day today, the coffee is strong. I finally got some rest. So a man's fit to task and challenge it. I was taught to hold my head high. Collect what is mine, make the best of what today has. Houston is filled with promise. Laredo's a beautiful place. And Galveston seems like that song that I love. Its meaning has not been erased. And so there are claims forgiven. And so there are things that are gone. Houston is filled with promise. Laredo's a beautiful place. And Galveston seems like that song that I loved. Its meaning has not been erased. Some things they fall to the wayside. The memories yet to be still. And so I am put to the test.
Thank you. Because the thing that, you know, what happens is kind of the way that we wrote songs all through the 1980s, because we toured the entire of the 1980s, was we'd have a new song and we would just kind of introduce it on stage and work it out in front of, you know, several nights worth of audiences. When the audiences were much smaller, they didn't know the words to the songs, they didn't know all the songs. Sometimes, often, I wouldn't announce it as a new song. Because then we would make a mistake or fuck up and people would know that it was new. Or I would announce, do you remember me announcing that it was a cover song? Like, here's a cover song from the 1960s. Yes. And we just do a new song. And so we got to work it out like that. You know, what happens on tour or when you're performing in front of an audience is that your adrenaline kind of creeps up. And mine was certainly by the third night of the Dublin rehearsals. My adrenaline had gone into full performance mode, so I had to really pull back on that. But what happens is the songs find their natural speed. You might think, the three of us might think with the drummer that we have the perfect tempo, and then you start playing it in front of an audience and it speeds up a little bit, and it either works or it doesn't work. But I think it gave you know, the material a lot more kind of a realness to it.
But there is a song, number four, that we really thought was going to be one of the great highlights of this rehearsal. And so I went in the studio and sang it. And Nobody said anything, as they often do. So I went home and I was all full of myself and I was like, man, that's a catchy one. They're gonna love it. It's really catchy. This, speaking of catchy, this is a girl's shirt. Who wants it? So anyway, I was all full of myself with this song, number four, and I was like, it's gonna be great, they're gonna love it. So I go back in the studio and the next day, we're in Vancouver here in Canada, and I go back in the next day and I'm like, so, wow, that new song. And Peter, I had written the chorus of, I had exactly lifted the chorus of the theme song from the very popular television show, Friends.
There's something that comes with experience, and I wouldn't say it's wisdom so much, but maybe just knowing your craft, and then hoping to elevate or lift outside of craft into something that's truly inspirational.
Thank you. I try not to judge a book by its placement on the shelf, but my ears start to ring when I hear these disconnected stories of your jousting days. Your eyes began to sting. Unfold a wallet photo aching to show what you're offering. I don't know what you're offering. I don't know what you're offering. You're offering.
Impeach? What does it mean? Are you kidding me?
You know the story?
Mm-mm.
Somebody wanted to cover a Burt Bacharach song, and they went to him and said, I want to do one of your lesser known songs. And he's like, why would you want to do that? They suck.
It's
not well known, it sucks. And it's just this whole idea that each song should be
a
single.
That's a total 60s thing, too. I interviewed Brian Wilson, and he's made some great records that haven't sold a lot. He refers to them as bombs. Oh, that was a bomb. And it was like, but it's a great record. Yeah, but it wasn't a hit. It's like, well, at the age of you've done this, you shouldn't have to worry about the hits. You shouldn't worry about making great music. But he's firmly of the belief that if it isn't in the top 10, then he's failed.
I remember you guys doing, on the 2005 tour, doing Living Well is the Best Revenge every day at Soundcheck after a certain point. And I had written that chorus. I was still furious. You know, we had released Bad Day as a single off of, that was on the Best Of record, right? And I was still furious at the American media for being such lapdogs to the Bush administration and basically just not doing their jobs, you know, and letting the whole country go down the toilet by not monitoring the policies and the choices and decisions made by this administration. Furious at, and yet I didn't it took another 2.5 years to write the verses, because I didn't even know to whom the song was directed.
All you sad and lost apostles hung my name and flare their nostrils, choking on the bones you tossed to them. I'm not one to sin and spend, but living well's the best revenge. Baby, I am calling you on. The battle's been lost, the war is not won. An addled republic, a bitter refund. The business first, flat earthers licking their wounds. The verdict is dire, the country's in ruin. Facing the sun, and where are we left to carry on? Until the day is done, until the day. Written our stories to entertain. These notions of glory and bull market gain. The teleprompt flutters, the power surge brings. An easy speak message falls into routine.
Favorite moment of the Dublin days. I walked in this record store and they just happened to be playing REM song. The guy looks at me and his face gets all white and says, "Oh, fuck me, is Michael Stipe with you?" And I went, "No, why? Do you have money or something?" He goes, "Well, I knew he was going to be in town, and I told my girlfriend if Michael Stipe came in the store, I'd marry her." And I went, "Really? So all I have to do is go get Michael and you have to get married?" Wow. And I was tempted. We had 4 more days there. It was a block from the Olympia, and it's like, he looked kind of like, please don't bring him in. He didn't have the nerve to say that to me. And I was just like, I could just totally ruin this guy's life. Or maybe it would make it better. I don't know. But
who knows?
That was.
I wonder what he got for seeing you.
This is a surprise. Go ahead. Got it. Okay, try it one more time. You know the words, you can sing along.
I'll be there for you.
So, no.
Yeah.
purpose. I'm floating up to the surface. I can hold my own, I can hold my breath. Hold you in countries, you hold me down. Staring down the barrel of a metal distance. God knows I've tried. Life was mine. Get out on the dance floor like you just don't care. Look at what I found. Everybody look around. Everybody's looking like they just don't care. Throw it on the fire. Throw it in the air. Kick it out on the dance floor like you just don't care. Give me some. Give me some. Give me some.
I should say, actually, also, this really is not a show. And I felt, I thought we're gonna do the rehearsal, it's gonna be fine. I'm not gonna get the adrenaline lift that I've written about so many times in so many R.E.M. songs. And I'm not gonna get the adrenaline lift that carries a normal human being through the course of a tour. And actually, yesterday, I realized that I had the adrenaline head pop had kicked in. And sadly, yeah, good for you. You don't have to be in the studio with me for the next 3 weeks. God help these guys.
Everybody here comes from somewhere that they would just as soon forget and disguise. Disguised as they know what it'd be like being there. No one saw your face, no one saw your fear. If that apparition just appeared, took you up and away from the space and sheer humiliation of your teenage station. Nobody cares, no one remembers or cares. No one cares if your fantasies are dressed up in travesties. Enjoy yourself with no regrets. So tell me, how is prison? Have they taught you how to listen? You've begun to bridge the schism. Pay attention, pay attention. Mr. Richards, your decision. Pay attention, pay attention. You can thump your chest and rattle, stand in front of your piano, but we know what's going on. Yes, we know what's going on. We're the children of the choir, hey, from the compound fire, hey. And we know what's going on. Yes, we know what's going on.
All right.
I
been lost inside my head. Echoes fall off me. I took the prize last night for complicatedness, for saying things I didn't mean and don't believe.
The melody?
Yeah.
Because it's super...
It's a great performance, too, I thought.
It's really good. All right. Because it's really subtle, the melody, but...
Yeah.
What'd you think?
The verses, I don't think should be quiet on your part. They just... It should be naked. I think by being so quiet, it's altered the space.
Yeah.
So I think it needs to be forceful.
I'll be singing out, but what I was really going for there was the melody,
because
I'm super downplaying it. I really love the version, that we did, the version of "Sing for the Submarine" that we did in the giant, what is that called, the grain silo? Yeah, that completely, doing that acoustically for the Vincent Moon project completely opened up my idea of what that song was and what it was about and its potential and turned it into something completely different. I mean, it's a sea shanty, and who would have, I didn't realize that writing it. It didn't occur to me that. Maybe it's thematic for a reason, but it is, it is what it is. You said that loving me was falling off a log. You always had a way with words. I'm in a barrel over Niagara Falls. I wonder if I am the first. That if I ask of you for just one wish, would you turn on me, you take the fifth? I think I have to drive and sing at the same time.
Right. I don't know about that.
Yeah, me neither.
Everybody hurts.
Yeah, that's a great idea, bro.
Yeah.
Thanks, but it's...
Yeah.
Mine was
a little wobbly.
Well, I was trying to move in close to you because you keep being in the shadows.
Well, it's not, for me, it's not a problem, but I've never sung on this song, so.
Well, shouldn't stop you now.
No, I'm just saying it was a little hard to find the part.
Sounded good in my ear.
Bone.
Oh, fuck. Yeah.
What?
Spody fucking odios. Why?
Steady, steady, hey, steady, steady. I don't wanna go until I'm good and ready. It's on my mind, it's in my mind. It's what I found, it's what I find. It's on my mind, it's in my mind. It's what I found, oh my, my, my. Hey, steady, steady, hey, steady, steady. I don't wanna go until I'm good and ready. Hey, steady, steady, hey, steady, steady. I don't wanna go until I'm good and ready. The music will provide the light you cannot resist. You cannot resist. You cannot resist. Yeah.
We made it to Taco Stand.
I won't be doubting you again. I won't be doubting you again. It's easy to laugh off, easy to brush aside. We're living our lives, we're here on the fly. It's easy to laugh off, easy to brush aside. We're living our lives, we are here on the fly. And I just happened by. I'm living my life, I'm here on the fly. And I just happened by. I just happened by.
Much. See you again soon. Good night. Safe home. Thanks a lot. Bye.
Mr. Richards, take one.
Mr. Richards, your position is a messenger pigeon left behind you when the camp moved on. You thought that you would listen, but the words had never crystallized into a truth that you might own. Hey, hey, Mr. Richards, your decision. Pay attention, pay attention. Mr. Richards, you're forgiven for a narrow lack of vision, but the fires are still raging on. The public's got opinions, and these consequences border on the compound that you raised where salads sang. Hey, hey, Mr. Richards, your decision. Pay attention, pay attention. Mr. Richards, your decision. Pay attention, pay attention. So listen, your intention, sign the paper. Stamp the ribbon, you're mistaken if you think we'll just forget. You can thump your chest and rattle, stand in front of your piano, but we know what's going on. Yes, we know what's going on. We're the children of the choir, hey. And we know what's going on. Mr. Richards, your conviction had us cheering in the kitchen. Now the jury's eating pigeon pie. So tell me, how is prison? Have they taught you how to listen? We've begun to bridge the schism. Pay attention, Mr. Richards, your decision. Pay attention. You can thump your chest and rattle, stand in front of your piano, but we know what's going on. Yes, we know what's going on.
We're the children of the choir. Hey, from the compound fire. Hey, and we know what's going on. Yes, we know what's going on. It feels in dreams that everything's there for you. The city breathes and pulses its few electron blue. I knew that you could see right through it. So this is where you give in to the machine. Lift up your voice, feel gravity's pull, and drown out the siren dream. Oh, it's all here where I keep it. It's all in the submarine. It's all a lot less frightening than we would have had it be. And that's the good news, my darling. It is what it's going to be. So sing, sing for the submarine.